ॐ वक्रतुण्डमहाकाय सूर्यकोटिसमप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वति नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणि विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा गुरवे सर्वलोकानां भिषजे भवरोगिणां निधये सर्वविद्यानां दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं साक्षात्कृतं दयानन्दं परमार्थस्वरूपिणं तत्त्वज्ञानप्रशास्तारं प्रणतोऽस्मि परं पदम्। ॐ सहनाभवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। ॐ नमो भगवते वैवस्वताय मृत्यवे ब्रह्मविद्याचार्याय नचिकेतसे च। You can repeat after me.
येषतेऽग्निर्नचिकेतस्वर्ग्यः
यमव्रणीथाद्वितीयेन वरेण एतमग्निं तवैव प्रवक्ष्यन्ति जना सह।
एवमग्निं तवैव प्रवक्ष्यन्ति जना सह।
तृतीयं वरं नचिकेतो वृणीष्व।
तृतीयं वरं नचिकेतो वृणीष्व।
This 19th mantra, Yamadharmaraja says, Tritiyam varam Nachiketo Vrinishva. In Nachiketa, you ask the third boon, Tritiyam Varam. I granted you three boons, you ask for the third boon. Then, Nachiketa, he asked this third boon. And as an introduction to the third boon, in the previous class we saw what was the content, the essence of the first two boons, and the third boon, which is going to ask how it is different from the first two boons. The first two boons, it is connected with, it is connected with Dvaita Prapancha. The first boon is for Pituhu Shantihi. So, Pituhu Shantiyartham Pratamam Pratama Varaha. Then this Dvitiyam Varam, the second boon, that is for Swargaloka Pala. Swargaloka Svargaloka Palapraptirtam Dvitiyaha Varaha. The second boon is for knowing the means to go to Svargaloka Prapti. So Svargaloka Prapti is the second boon, and Pratama, that is first boon, is for the Pituhu Shanti. So one is Ihaloka Palam. Pituhu Shanti is Ihaloka Palam. That Palam, the result of that is connected with this Loka. Ihaloka. Bhuloka. The Palam which can be enjoyed in this Loka. It is Ihaloka Palam. And the Palam which can be enjoyed after this life, that is Paraloka Palam, Swarga Palam. So the first bone symbolizes Ihaloka Palam, and the second bone symbolizes Swargaloka Palam, Paraloka Palam. So if you combined these two bones, Ihaloka Palam and Paraloka Palam, what are they? They represent the result of any karma. The possibilities of any karma what you do, either it is for the sake of this world or for the sake of the other world. Either you do an action to gain an object in this world now or before you depart from this world, the result of the action you want to enjoy. That is one type of karma. The second type of karma is the result what you want to enjoy after this life. Ultimately, both are connected to karma. And that is what the Karma Kanda portion of the Veda deals with. Karma Kanda portion of the Veda gives you a lot of karma. It gives you a lot of karma which are connected to certain karma palam. For accomplishing those karma palam, Shastra gives a varieties of karma. So karma means either it is for Ihaloka or Paraloka. It is connected with karma palam. So karma kanda portion of the Veda, it all talks about karma for gaining objects in the world Ihaloka, or for gaining Loka, or for gaining certain pleasures in the Loka after death. Therefore, it all the representative of the Dvaita Prapancha. Dvaitam means that which is objectifiable. That which is objectifiable, that is Dvaitam. It's all connected with the Dvaita Prapancha. There you will be there, and there will be other Karakas will be there. So you and other than you. So you as the enjoyer and all other things which are given to you for your enjoyment. So two things will be there. Two means not literally two, it is more than one. That is Dvaita Prapancha. So the Veda Purva, it all connected with the Dvaita Prapancha. When you say Dvaita, it is other than you. Therefore, it is Anatma. You are Atma. You being Atma, that is what the teaching of the Veda. You, the essential nature of you is Chaitanyam Atma. And when you deal with Anatma, when you deal with Dvaita Prapancha, then it is nothing but Anatma Prapancha, other than you. Because there is a perception of more than one. Duality comes. Therefore, the whole Prapancha, it is nothing but Anatma Prapancha, it is Dvaita Prapancha. Where Dvaitam is appreciated, there you appreciate objects or things or persons other than you. Therefore, Anatma also comes. So this accepting the Anatma Prapancha, Dvaita Prapancha, temporarily it is called Adhyaropa, superimposition. The subject matter of the Veda Purva is Anatma Prapancha, it is Dvaita Prapancha. That is what the content of the first two bones asked by Nachiketa. So Veda also gives you certain karma for accomplishing certain karma pala. So it's all connected with Dvaita Prapancha, Anatma Prapancha, where Karta is there and Karma is there, and therefore Karma Palam is there. Karta, Karma, Karma Palam, all the three are there. Therefore Dvaita, that Dvaita comes when you accept other Karakas. Therefore it is Adhyaropa, superimposition. Is that the teaching of the Veda? That cannot be the teaching of the Veda. If you take the whole Veda as only one Shastram, that is what the Dvaitins do. Dvaitin, I mean that Mimamsakas, they do. For the Mimamsakas, the whole Shastram, it is only one Shastram. The whole Shastram is only one Shastram. There is no Veda Purva or Vedanta for Mimamsakas. And for them, Swargaloka Prapti, Swargaloka Palam, that is Moksha for them. So therefore, when you say Swargaloka Palam, Swargaloka Prapti, it means you go to the Swargaloka. So you are there, you as the Jivatma is there, and the Jivatma has to reach the Swargaloka. So therefore, there is a travel involved. You have to travel to the Swargaloka. Attaining Swargaloka is Moksha. This is how the Mimamsakas, they interpret. So you and the place of destination, it is there. Therefore, Dvaitam is there. Therefore, they are all Dvaitins. They all talk about more than one. Two things are there for them. The Karta is there, that is Jivatma is there, and the Jivatma has to reach the Swargaloka. Therefore, for them, the whole Shastra is one Shastra. Even when they read the words of the Upanishads, the Vedanta, they will interpret it also as a part of the karma. That is how they interpret. For them, the whole Shastram is one Shastram, and they are the advocates of Dvaita philosophy, whereas for us, it is not one Shastram, it is two Shastram. The whole Veda is not one, it is divided into two. Though we divide a Shastram into two, but for us, our Tatparyam is what? Our Tatparyam is Advaitam. According to us, the Tatparyam of the Shastram, the Vedanta, is Advaitam. Though we divide the Shastram into two, as Veda Purva and Veda Anta, the Tatparyam of the Vedanta is Advaitam, non-duality. That is the Tatparyam of Advaitins. That is the Tatparyam of the Shastram also. Shastram gives the Veda Purva for certain people who has got certain desires and who want to accomplish certain things in this world or in the other world. For them, Veda Purva, it gives a lot of karma and the ritual karma, mantras, everything is given. And those who have understood the limitations of the karma and the karma pala, those who have understood the limitations of dharma, artha, kama, purushartha, those who have grown out of this limitation, understanding the limitations of the karma, and those who want to gain that, which gives them ultimate security, ultimate happiness, ultimate shanti, they arrive at Vedanta. They arrive at the end portion of the Veda, that is Vedanta, and the Tatparyam of the Vedanta is, the Upanishads is Advaitam, that is our Tatparyam. So Therefore, first we talk about Adhyaropa. First, we Shastram accepts as though Dvaitam is there. That is why the Vedapurva prescribes a lot of rituals for the person. It accepts as though Dvaitam is there. But later, the same Shastram, when the person grows out after understanding the limitations of the Karmapala, when he grows out, then the Shastram later it provides him the teaching of Vedanta. Therefore, two Shastrams are there, and two Shastram has got two different Adhikaris. For the Vedapurva, the Adhikari is different. For Vedanta, Adhikari is different. Why? Because Anubandha Chatushtayam of Vedapurva and Vedanta are different. The subject matter of Vedapurva and Vedanta are different. Therefore, the qualifications required for the candidate, for the person, for Vedapurva and Vedanta, they are different. Vedapurva, for pursuing Vedapurva, you must be a Dharmarthi or Kamarthi or Artharthi. But for Vedanta, you must be a Mokshaarthi. Having understood the limitations of Vedapurva, one comes to Vedanta, which does the Apavada, the superimposition. Initially, you accepted the Dvaita Prapancha, the Anatma Prapancha, you appreciated Anatma, considering that to be real. And later, when you come to Vedanta, Vedanta will negate Anatma and it will point you, it will teach you that everything is Atma. Vedanta will negate that which is not real. That which is not real is Anatma. That which is not real is Dvaitam. The Dvaitam will be negated by the teaching of Apavada. Negating the superimposed Dvaita Anatma is the later part. It's the later part of the Veda. That is later teaching of the Veda. That is Vedanta. That is Apavada. So, Adhyaropa and Apavada, that is the prakriya. Initially, Adhyaropa is presented, and we should not stop at Adhyaropa. If we stop with Adhyaropa, that is not the Tatparyam of the Vedanta. And the Tatparyam of Vedanta is Advaitam. Therefore, if you stop at Adhyaropa, then you will end up with the conclusion that I am Karta, and other karakas are present, so there will be a continuous samsara. Because the seed of samsara is this. What is the seed of samsara? The seed of samsara is that I am karta, I am bhokta. That is the problem. I am the doer. I am the enjoyer. Enjoyer means I am the person who enjoys sukham. I am the person who enjoys dukkham. I am limited. I don't have peace, I am not secured. This is samsara, and samsara bija is because of ajnanam, not knowing the real nature, my swarupa, not knowing the swarupa of myself. That is ajnanam. That ajnanam is the cause of samsara, and the samsara manifests in the form of myself taken to be a karta, bhokta, etc. That is samsara. If you stop with Adhyaropa, if you stop with Vedapurva, then samsara will not go. Samsara will remain. Even if you go to Swargaloka, samsara will continue to exist and in a dormant form. After Swargaloka, after enjoying the Swargaloka for a certain period of time, again you will come back to the Prithivi. Kshine loke, kshine punye martyalokam vishanti. Therefore, the samsara will never end. it is a cycle, it will go on and on if you stop it adhyaropa, unless apavada is done. And that is what the last portion of the Veda does. Veda Anta Bhaga, the subject matter of Veda Anta Bhaga, that is Vedanta, is Advaita Atma. In short, apavada, the negation of the superimposition, it is done by the last portion of the Veda. And that is why here, Nachiketa, he did not stop with the first two bones. Later, he has the third bone that completes the bone on the part of Nachiketa and also the teaching part of the Shastram. So, Apavada is what we are going to deal with. And this, the third bone, the content of the third bone is Atma. The content of the third bone is Atma. And this bone, because it is deal with the Atma, and therefore it is opposed to the first two bones. The first two bones deal with Anatma, Dvaita Prapancha. Whereas the third bone, it deals with Advaita Atma. Advaita Atma, which is unnegatable. The third bone is dealing with the Atma, and the Atma is going to be presented as the Adhishtanam. As the Adhishtanam, the truth of the entire Dvaita Prapancha. The entire Dvaita Prapancha is superimposed on the Atma, which is the Adhishtanam. Therefore, the Atma, which is Advaita Atma, it will be presented as the basis of the superimposition, which is in the form of duality. Therefore, the third bone, it deals with Adhishtana Atma. Adhishtana Atma, and is going to negate what has been dealt by the first two bones. To unfold the Atma as non-dual, the duality which is superimposed on Atma will be negated. Therefore, the third bone deals with Apavada. The first two bones deals with Adhyaropa, and the third bone deals with Apavada. And Bhashyakara, he shows the contrast. He shows the contrast between the first two bones and the third bone. The first two bones, is calls it as a Dvaita Prapancha, connected with Anatma Prapancha, Adhyaropa, and the third bones, it involves the negation of Anatma, therefore Advaita Atma. And now we will read the mantra, and then we will read what Bhashyakara, in his introduction to this mantra, what he has said, and also the commentary on this, the mantra. Yeyam prete vichikitsa manushye.
Yeyam prete vichikitsa manushye.
Astit yeke nayam astiti chayke.
Astit yeke nayam astiti chayke.
Etad vidyam anushishtas tvayagam.
Etad vidyam anushishtas tvayagam.
Varanamesha varas tritiyaha.
Varanamesha varas tritiyaha.
Okay. I'll give the meaning of the individual words of the mantra. Yeyam, ya iyam, prete vichikitsa manushye, asti iti yeke, na ayam asti iti cha yeke. Etat vidyam anushishtaha tvaya agam varanam esha varastritiyaha. So, prete manushye. Prete manushye, it is gate manushye, mrite manushye, prete manushye, it is the person who has gone, who is dead. With regard to prete manushye, with regard to the person who has gone, who is dead, yam vichikitsa asti, yam vichikitsa, this doubt exists. What is the doubt? Ayam asti iti eke, this exists iti eke vadanti. Some people say that jivatma survives. Ayam atma asti iti eke vadanti. Some people say this jivatma still continues, still survives death. Whereas ayam jivatma na asti iti cha eke vadanti. This jivatma doesn't survive death iti eke vadanti. Some people say. This is what the first two line says. Ya iyam prete vichikitsa manushye asti iti eke nayam asti iti cha chaike. When you do the anvaya, you get the sentence like this. Prete manushye ya iyam vichikitsa asti yat ayam atma asti iti eke vadanti ayam atma nasti na asti iti eke vadanti. With regard to a human being who is dead, some people say it doesn't exist after death. Some people say he continues to exist. Etad vidyam anushishtaha tvaya agam. Agam etad vidyam tvaya anushishtaha. This knowledge is what I want to be instructed by you. Tvaya anushishtaha, to be instructed by you. Varanam yeshaha, yeshaha varaha, tritiyaha bhavati. And this is the third boon. Among all the boons, this is my third boon. This is what Nachiketa asked the Yamadharma Raja. If Atma is known to oneself, if Atma is known to oneself, then one need not ask this question to a guru. If Atma is known to you already, then you need not ask this question to the guru. And therefore, since it is not totally known, and since this is a controversial subject matter, which is not available for your Pratyaksha Pramanam, which is not available for your Anumana Pramanam, or for that matter, any pramanam, it is not available other than Shastra Pramanam, Shabda Pramanam. Therefore, since there is a controversy whether there is an Atma, Jivatma, there is an Atma or not, which survives the death of the physical body, therefore the question arises in Nachiketa. If there is no Atma, then there is no problem. But if there is such Atma, then what is the nature of that Atma? Because some people, they identify with the Atma with the body. Some people identify Atma with the mind. Some people identify Atma with the sense organs. Some identify with the Buddhi. Some identify even with his own son. The son, one's own putra, son is taken to be one's Atma. There are different darshanas are there. Taking oneself to be one, taking Atma to be the body, taking Atma to be the mind or the senses, they're all come under the Charvaka, materialistic philosophy. For them, the body is the Atma. The body, once the body dies, the Atma also dies. Nothing continues to exist after the death of the body. That is why the Charvaka, the materialistic philosophy, they say, as long as you live, you enjoy the world. Ranam krutva ghritam pebet. Even you buy money from others and enjoy and the ghee. You take ghee. Even if you don't have money to buy ghee, you borrow from somebody and take ghee. Ghee is upalakshana for enjoyment. Because for them, the life is meant only for enjoyment. There is no papa, there is no punya for their karma. There is no other loka for them. There is no loka to be reached. There is no karma to be reaped after death. They all materialistic philosophy. Charuvaka. For them, the body is the Atma. And for under Charvakas, for some people it is Indriyas are the Atma. For some people, mind is the Atma. And for some people, only sense organs are the Atma. But it is confined only to body, mind, sense organs. They cannot think anything more than that. But here, the first two bone, if you see, the first bone, of course, it is with Pitu Shantihi. The second bone, if you see, the second bone is for the people who want to go to Swargaloka, who want to enjoy Swargaloka after death. It means Swargaloka can be reached only after death. After Ihaloka, Sukha Dukkha Anubhava, only Swargaloka Prapti is possible. After Ihaloka, after completing the lifespan in this Bhumi, then only going to Swargaloka is possible. And for going to Swargaloka, you have to do the karma, you have to do the certain ritual while you are alive in this earth. And after death, where do you go? You go to Swargaloka. Who goes to Swargaloka? Does your body go to Swargaloka? Does your mind go to Swargaloka? Or only the sense organs? No. The person is dead. His body lies in front of you. The person's body is there. But what has gone? His life has gone. The prana has gone. Therefore, there must be something existing. That there must be something existing which survives the death of the body. Which survives the death of the body. That is obvious. That is that because some things survives after death. That is why the person while living he had done the karma for going to Swargaloka. Otherwise he would not have done. If a person had done some karma to go to Swargaloka, it implies that the person knows that he survives after death. Our Veda also confirms that. Veda Purva gives a lot of ritual for going to Swargaloka. So it confirms that something survives after death. But here, Nachiketa he presents a question because that knowledge is not clear. There is a vagueness with regard to that. The second bone, he talked about the Jivatma which goes to Swargaloka and enjoying Swargaloka. So that Jivatma is connected to the Karmakanda portion of the Veda. So that Jivatma is discussed in the Karmakanda. That Jivatma has to do certain karma while living. Whereas in Jnanakanda portion of the Veda, that is Vedanta, there is also a Jivatma talked about. Therefore, as though there are two Jivatmas. One Jivatma is connected to Karmakanda of the Veda and another Jivatma connected to Jnanakanda of the Veda. Jnanakanda is Vedanta. In Karmakanda, for Karmakanda Jivatma, that Jivatma has to do certain karma. It is a limited Jivatma because it is a karta. It is a karta and there are other karakas are there. Karma, karana, adhikarana, apadana, all the karakas are available. If karta is there, other karakas, other factors of action will be there. Therefore, dvaitam will be there. Therefore, it is a karmakanda jivatma. And for that karmakanda jivatma, only the swarga loka and other lokas are prescribed. Because that jivatma wanted to go or wants to go to those lokas. Whereas that jnanakanda jivatma, it is different. It is different from the karmakanda jivatma. That jnanakanda jivatma, it is not limited. It is not a karta. It is not a bhokta. At the same time, it is not different from paramatma also. It is not a karta, it is not a bhokta, it is not different from the paramatma. Therefore, Nachiketa says to Yamadharma Raja, when a jiva dies, when a jivatma dies, some says there is a jivatma which survives the death, and there are some people who say that there is no jivatma which survives the death. Therefore, I want to know clearly of this surviving jivatma. I don't know exactly what the jivatma is. Therefore, etad vidyam tvaya agam anushishtaha. So, the Nachiketa, he presents the vagueness with regard to the knowledge of jivatma. And he wants to know about the surviving jivatma. This vagueness comes because in the Purva, the Karmakanda jivatma is talked about, and in the Jnanakanda jivatma is talked about. And this Karmakanda jivatma alone has to take another janma or go to another loka depending on its papa and punya. So it has to undergo, it has to travel. There is a travel involved for the karmakanda jivatma. Travel either in the form of going to the other loka or travel in the form of taking another sharira, punarjanma, based on the punya papa in his sanchita karma. That jivatma has to travel, it has to pass through the cycle of samsara. Whereas jnanakanda jivatma, it doesn't undergo any change. Therefore, the doubt arises, is what is the nature of this jivatma? What jivatma? He doesn't ask about the karmakanda jivatma. Karmakanda jivatma, that he knows, that survives and that undergoes, goes to various loka and that undergoes changes depending on its karma palam, that he knows. Therefore, the question here is not about karmakanda jivatma. The question is about jnanakanda jivatma. Because karmakanda jivatma, it being limited, being a karta bhokta, therefore it has to follow its course, it follows the path based on its action, based on the karma. Whereas this jnanakanda jivatma, about which only Nachiketa had doubt. What is this swarupa? What is the nature of this jivatma which the Upanishads talk about? So therefore, the question here what Nachiketa asked is not about the karmakanda jivatma. If it is about karmakanda jivatma, then he would have asked in the second boon itself, but he did not ask. He knows very well the karmakanda jivatma is limited, it is a karta, and it survives after death and it goes to various lokas or takes punacharma, all these things he knows. And here it doesn't ask about the karmakanda jivatma. Question is relevant to jnanakanda jivatma. And jnanakanda jivatma, which is identical with paramatma, what is its real nature? What is its swarupam? That is what I want to know. This is the third boon of Nachiketa. So it means what? Nachiketa is asking the knowledge about Atma. Atma Vidya is what he wanted to gain. And Bhagavad Pada, in his introduction to this mantra, he says, Eta Vadhi Atikrantena Vidhi Pradishedharthena Mantra Brahmanena Avagantavyam Yatu Yatu Varadvaya Suchitam Vastu Na Atmatat Vishaya Yathatmya Vijnanam. He says, from the Atikrantena, Atikrantena means from the portion which has gone by. That is the Veda Purva Bhaga. Veda Purva Bhaga, the subject matter of Veda Purva Bhaga is do's and don'ts. Vidhi Pratisheda. Vidhi is do's. Pratisheda is don'ts. Do's and don'ts. The subject matter of the Veda Purva Bhaga, which is in the form of do's and don'ts, what you can gain is only this much. Etavadhi. Etavadhi, only this much. It is limited. Etavadhi means only this much you can avagantavyam, this much you can understand, this much you can gain, this much you can be gained from the Veda Purva Bhaga. Veda Purva Bhaga, it gives a limited knowledge about Anatma. It gives a limited knowledge about Dvaita Prapancha. That is what is indicated by the first two boons. Yatu Varadvaya Suchitam Vastu. Yatu Varadvayam. By the Varadvayam two boons, what is indicated is only the limited knowledge about the Dvaita Prapancha, not about Advaitam. Na Atma Tattva Vishaya Yathatmya Vijnanam. Not about the right knowledge of the reality of the Atma. Not about Advaita Atma. Bhagavad Pada, he presents the limitations of the Veda Purva. The limitations of the Veda Purva, it has got limitation in only giving you the knowledge of do's and don'ts. Vidhi Pratisheda. Whereas it doesn't give you the knowledge of the reality of the Atma. And this Advaita Anatma is the subject matter of do's and don'ts. It consists of three factors. One is the action, the karma. Second one is the cause of the action. The third one is the result of the action. These three are falsely superimposed on Advaita Atma. Karma, Karaka and Pala. Karma, Karaka, Pala. These three are falsely superimposed on Advaita Atma. Kriya, Karaka, Pala, Adhyaropa, Lakshanasya. Svabhavika Ajnanasya Samsara Bijasya Nivrityartam. The Kriya is there, action is there, Karaka is there, the factors of action is there, and the Karma Pala is there. So these three are superimposed falsely on the Advaita Atma, and due to avidya, ignorance, Ajnanasya, which is Svabhavika, which naturally exists in the people, Svabhavikasya, and that which becomes the seed of Samsara, Samsara Bijasya, Advaita Anatmana. This is the subject matter of the Veda Purva. Therefore, in the following portion of the Veda, for the purpose of negating apavada, nivrityartham, for the purpose of negating such a dvaita anatma, the dvaita anatma, the advaita atma jnanam, the knowledge of the non-difference between oneself, the Atma, and the Brahman. The Brahma Atma Ekatva Vijnanam, that must be taught, that must be imparted, Vaktavyam, which is the cause of action and the result of action, which gives the palam of moksha, Atyantika Nishreyasa Prayojanam. Therefore, with the intention of telling this, the following portion of the Upanishad begins. This is how the Bhagavad Pada, he presents the introduction to this mantra. Ataha vidhi pratishedhartha vishayasya atmani kriyakaraka pala adhyaropa lakshanasya svabhavikasya ajnanasya samsara bijasya nivrityartam tad viparita brahmatmaikatva jnanam vijnanam kriyakaraka pala adhyaropa lakshana shunyam atyantika nishreyasa priyojanam vaktavyam iti uttaraha grantaha arabhyate. Uttaraha grantaha, the later portion of the Upanishad is started. Why? In order to impart the teaching. What is the teaching? Tad viparita brahmatmaikatva vijnanam. Viparita. Viparita is contrary, opposite. Opposite to what? Opposite to the Adhyaropa. Adhyaropa we have seen. Adhyaropa is Vedapurva Bhaga. Vedapurva Bhaga, it deals with Kriya, Karaka and Pala. The three factors are superimposed on the Atma. That is because of the inborn ignorance. That is the samsara bija. Because the ignorance is there, therefore one takes oneself to be a karta and does varieties of karma. And therefore on that person, on that atma, that kriya, karaka, pala, they are all superimposed. I take myself to be a karta, I take myself to be a karma, I take myself to be all the other karakas, or all the other karakas are available for my disposition. So all these are possible because of the ajnanam, because of this svabhavika ajnanam, the ajnanam with which we are born. So this has to be removed. Therefore, viparita jnanam, contrary to this svabhavika, this inborn knowledge, this inborn ajnanam, inborn ignorance, the later portion of the Upanishad, it is going to teach you kriyakaraka pala adhyaropa lakshana shunyam shunya atma, that which is atma, which is devoid of the kriya, karaka and pala, which is devoid, which is not connected to kriya, which is not connected to karaka, or which doesn't enjoy any pala. And what is that atma which is not different from Brahma, which is not different from Paramatma? So Jivatma Paramatma Aikyam, the oneness, the essential oneness of the Jivatma and Paramatma, that Jnanam, that Vijnanam, that Brahmatmaikatva Vijnanam, which is the Atyantika Nishreyasa Priyojanam, that knowing the identity of oneness, knowing the identity of the Jivatma and Paramatma, which is the moksha, that has to be taught. For that sake, Uttara Grantaha Arabhyate, the later portion of the Upanishad is started. So here Bhagavad Pada clearly demarcates the first part, which has gone up to the 19th mantra, and the second part. The first part, it talked about Adhyaropa. Now that has to be resolved. So that Nivrityartham Uttara Grantaha Arabhyate, the later portion of the Upanishad is started. And for that, he says, for this, Bhagavad Pada, he gives, who is qualified for this jnanam? who is qualified for this Uttara Grantha? That also Bhagavad Pada says. Yataha Purvasmat Karma Gocharat Sadhya Sadhana Lakshanat Anityat Viraktasya Atmajnane Adhikaraha Iti Tat Nindartham Putradi Upanyasena Pralobhanam Kriyate. The person, he has to be Viraktasya, he has to be detached. Virakta means Vairagya. The person must have attained certain Vairagyam, certain dispassion of what or from what? From the Ihaloka and Paraloka Palam. The Palam is the result of action, result of action which comes in the form of Sukham, either in this Loka or in the other Loka. That must be given up. One must be detached with regard to that. And that is the, that comes under the Karmakanda. Karmakanda portion of the Veda. Karma Gocharat. That Igaloka Paraloka Palam is, it is Karma Gocharam. It is obtainable by karma. Because it is obtainable by karma, therefore they are Sadhya Sadhana Lakshanat. There is a Sadhyam, the end to be achieved. And there are certain Sadhanam, the means for accomplishing the end. Therefore, the first boon, two boon, which represents the Veda Purva, which is characterized by Sadhya Sadhana Lakshanam, which is characterized by the means and the end. The means, certain means are prescribed for certain ends. And what is the nature of those means and end? They are impermanent. They are anitya. So, Sadhya Sadhana Lakshanat Anityat Viraktasya, the one who is virakta, who is dispassionate with regard to the limited means and the limited ends, having known the nature of, having known the impermanent nature of those things, then the person becomes a qualified person for the acquisition of Atmajnanam. Atmajnane Adhikaraha Iti. Therefore, to show the defects of this Dvaita Prapancha, to show the limitations of Dharmartha Kama Purushartha, Tanindartham, to, in order to show the limitation and also to criticize it, the following part of the story is going to come. The story is not complete. Nachiketa, he asked for the third boon on Yamadharma Raja. He will test the student and then only he will teach him, will give him this vidya. Because he has immediately, he will not give. Therefore, Yamadharma Raja now is going to put his student to test. He is going to tempt him with various things which he is going to offer. Why does he offer that? Because to show the limitations of the Dvaita Prapancha, to show the limitations of anything which can be attained by this Sadhya and Sadhana, by the means and end, which is the subject matter of Veda Purva. So he will show the limitations of Veda Purva and he will teach him the Vedanta. Therefore, the story will continue the later part. It is going to come from the next shloka onwards. Yamadharma Raja immediately will not give that teaching. Nachiketa asked, now Yamadharma Raja will find whether Nachiketa is a qualified student. Already, Yamadharma Raja had got an hint about the student. He had got a wonderful memory. He verbatim repeated whatever he taught him about the ritual. That qualification he had, but what about the other qualifications which is required for the Vedanta student? Sadhana Chatushtaya Sampatti. That part of the story is going to come. Now, coming back to this mantra. Yeyam Vichikitsa. Vichikitsa means Samshayaha. एयं चिकित्सा संशयः प्रेते मनुष्ये अस्ति इति एके अस्ति इति एके That is the doubt with regarding the atma of a dead person, which is known and it is argued. Some say there is atma, which is sharira indriya mano buddhi vyatiriktaha. Some say that atma is different from sharira, sharirat vyatiriktaha, and different from indriya, different from manaha, different from buddhihi. Iti. And Dehantara Sammandi Atma Asti Iti Eke. So that Atma which is connected to the other body, Dehantara which is connected, which is survives the death of one body and takes another body, Dehantara Sammandi Atma Asti Iti Eke Vadanti. Some people say it exists. Whereas some say Na Ayam. Na ayam evam vidaha atma asti. Some say there is no such atma exists which travels from body to body. It is not there. And therefore, because of this controversial opinions, ataha asmakam na pratyakshena na nava anumanena nirnaya vijnanam. We cannot conclusively say, we don't have a conclusive knowledge regarding this Atma, either by Pratyaksha Pramanam nor by Anumana Pramanam. Therefore, Etat Vijnana Adhinaha Hi Paraha Purushartaha Iti Ataha Etat Vidyam Vijaniyam Agam Anushishtaha Nyapitaha Tvaya. Because one is not able to arrive at this conclusive knowledge regarding Atma, because there are varied opinions regarding the nature of the Atma, and the highest Purusharta, that Moksha, it depends on the conclusive knowledge of this Atma, and let this Atma Jnanam be taught to me by you. Etat Vidyam, Etat Atma Jnanam, Vijaniyam, Anushishtaha, Nyapitaha. It is to be instructed, to be taught by you. And among the boons, Varanam, Yeshaha, Tritiyaha, Varaha, Avashishtaha. So that boon which is left, Avashishtaha. What is that boon? The third boon which you asked me to ask is this boon. That is the knowledge regarding the Atma. So I want to know the Swarupa, the nature of the Atma. The conclusive knowledge regarding Atma is what I want to know. So Nachiketa, he asked the third boon. And here, by asking the third boon, by asking for the Atma Vidya, the Upanishad also, it says that knowledge regarding the Atma can be gained only from the teacher. Here, by this question, the Nachiketa, he became the disciple, and Yamadharma Raja, he becomes the teacher. And the evil, because he has become the teacher, that is why he has got the privilege to put his Shishya to test. Now the student, now Nachiketa, he exhibited his willingness to become a student of Yamadharma Raja to receive the teaching. Now, Yamadharma Raja, he has to accept him, but he will not accept Nachiketa as he is now. Because he asked this question, Nachiketa will not give him the teaching immediately. Though he had got a little inkling about the quality of Nachiketa, in order to show it to the people, in order to show it to the students of Vedanta, Nachiketa will try to tempt him by giving variety of offers. First, he will say, I will not give, you ask me other boon. Then Nachiketa will insist on getting this boon only. Then Yamadharma Raja will try to tempt him by offering a lot of wealth, a lot of vehicles, and this the whole. He will make him. He will. He say, I will make you the king of the whole jagat. Then also, Nachiketa will not budge, and he will strongly hold on to this, the third boon. That shows his commitment to gain this knowledge. That is an important quality of the student that Nachiketa will exhibit. From this only, we all come to know the qualifications of an adhikari. The sadhana chatushtaya sampatti, what we often discuss, all these topics, all these qualifications, we know only from such conversation between the teacher and the disciple, which the Upanishad going to present from the 21st mantra that we will see in the next class. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.
Thank you, Ji. Dhanyavadah.
Ji, the authentic Nishreya, sir. Enna sunninga adukku konjam thirupi.